हेलो ऑल, आई एम पुनश्री पाटिल फ्रॉम AISSMS IIT कॉलेज पुणे. सो टुडे वी हैव टू लर्न अबाउट द लिस्ट कॉम्प्रिहेंशन इन पायथॉन. सो फर्स्ट वी हैव टू सी द व्हाट इज मीन बाय लिस्ट. सो लिस्ट इज द कलेक्शन ऑफ द एलिमेंट्स. सो लिस्ट कॉम्प्रिहेंशन, व्हाई वी यूज द लिस्ट कॉम्प्रिहेंशन. सो लिस्ट कॉम्प्रिहेंशन इज द इजी वे टू रीड द कॉम्पैक्ट द क्रिएटिंग द लिस्ट फ्रॉम एनी एग्जिस्टिंग इटरेबल ऑब्जेक्ट्स. सो इट इज़ द सिंपल वे टू क्रिएट द न्यू लिस्ट फ्रॉम द वैल्यूज इन द लिस्ट यू आर ऑलरेडी हैव. सो इट इज़ द जनरली द सिंगल लाइन ऑफ क्लोथ इनक्लोज्ड विद इन द स्क्वेयर ब्रैकेट. सो इट इज़ यूज्ड इन द स्ट्रिंग्स, टपल्स, सेट, डेटा फ्रेम्स, एरे लिस्ट एंड एनी अदर लिस्ट. सो बिफोर वी स्टार्ट लिस्ट कॉम्प्रिहेंशन, फर्स्ट वी सी द सिंटैक्स फॉर लिस्ट कॉम्प्रिहेंशन. सो देर आर द थ्री कंपोनेंट्स फॉर लूप, कंडीशन एंड एक्सप्रेशन एंड आउटपुट. सो हियर इज द सिंटैक्स. वी हैव टू डिफाइन द लिस्ट इज इक्वल टू एक्सप्रेशन फॉर दैट आइटम इन द लिस्ट एंड इफ कंडीशन. सो हियर इज द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दैट लिस्ट कॉम्प्रिहेंशन सिंटैक्स. X plus 1 is the output. We have to check the condition for loop, that is for x in range 5. If x is divided by 2, that is the condition. Okay. So next one is the simple list comprehension using the for loop. So here is the syntax for that. We have to use the list is equal to in square bracket expression for item in iterable. So here in example we have to declare the list as the 1 to 10 numbers, and we have to use the syntax, that is a is equal to x for x in list. So and we have to print that list, that is a. So we will get the output 1 to 10 numbers. So we have to use here only one single line of code, that is a is equal to x for x in list. Next one is the list comprehension with the single and nested if condition. So nesting means we have to use the if condition within that if condition. So here is the syntax for that, is the list is equal to expression for item in iterable and if condition. So here is the example, that is x for x in list, and we have to check here if x is greater than 4. So we have to define here list is the 1 to 10 number. So we have first 4 numbers will not be present, because we have to check here condition if x is greater than 4. So output will be 5 to 10 numbers. So we have to define here the code in the single line. Okay, then next we have to use the nested if condition. So syntax for that is the expression for item in iterable and if conditions, that is number of if conditions, nested if condition. So here is the example, in that we have to check the if conditions if x is greater than 4 and x mod is equal to 0. We have to check here two if conditions, so output will be 6, 8 and 10. So next one is the Python using list comprehension in Python using the else condition. So here is the syntax for that, is the if condition and else in default expression for item in that iterable. So next one is the single and multiple if and else condition. So here is the example for that. We have to use here if in if else condition or multiple else condition. So next one is the list comprehension with multiple if and else. So we have to use here in the example, see here x into 2, if x is mod 2 is equal to 0, else x into 3, if x mod 3 is equal to 0. Our in else part we have to check the x into 4 for x in number. So we have to use here multiple else conditions. So next is the list comprehension with nested for loops. So list comprehension in Python call also include the for loop. It is used to create the more complex expressions. So here is the example for that. That is, we have to use here list 1 and 2, that is number 1 to 3 and 3 to 1. And we have to print that number. So we have to get the output like this. So next one is the, what are the benefits of the list comprehension. So first is the concise and readable code. That is, the list comprehension used to write the concise and readable code. It is allows you to express the complex compression in the single line, reducing the amount of code that you need to write. It is the faster execution, easier to debug, more Pythonic, and can handle in the large data set. So these are the benefits of the list comprehension.